You can easily build a deep learning model with the Keras Sequential API or Functional API. But it is difficult to create complex models with these methods. To build flexible models, it's a better idea to use the subclassing API. To show this, let's handle a regression problem using the California housing dataset. This dataset shows the house prices and features of these houses in California. To download this dataset, let's use the Fetch California Housing function in scikit-learn. Let's write from sklearn datasets import Fetch California Housing. Now, let's assign this dataset to the housing variable using this function. Let's write housing equals Fetch California Housing. Cool, we have downloaded our dataset. Let's move on to data preprocessing. What we're going to do now is split the dataset into training and testing sets. To do this, we're going to use the train test split function in scikit-learn. Let's import this function first. Let's write from sklearn model selection import train test split. After that, let's create the training and test sets using this function. Note that the model is built with the training set and the model is tested with the test set. Xtrain, xtest, ytrain, ytest equals train test split. Housing.data, housing.target, random state equals 42. Nice, we've created our datasets. Let's move on to the model building step. To build the model, we're going to use the Keras subclassing API. This approach allows you to build flexible deep learning models. First, let's import TensorFlow and Keras. Import TensorFlow as TF. After that, from TensorFlow, import Keras. Note that, in the model subclassing, we're going to define the layers in the constructor and then build the model with these layers in the call method. The model we're going to build consists of two inputs and one output, like this. To do this, we're going to create a class using the subclassing API. Class, MyModel. When creating the model with subclassing approach, we're going to inherit from the Keras model class. This allows us to use all the variables and methods of a superclass inside another class. Let's set TF Keras model. Now, we're going to use the init function to create an instance of this class. In this function, we're going to define the layers that will be included in the model. Let's start with the def keyword. Let's write def init. We know from object-oriented programming that the first parameter of the init function is self. Now, let's set the parameters. We need the number of neurons and the activation function to create a layer, right? Now, let's pass them as parameters to the init function. Let's set units equals 30, activation equals relu. What we're going to do now is to use the super keyword. With this keyword, we can specify our own attributes while using the attributes of the superclass. Let's write super init. Let's go ahead and create the layers we'll use to build the model. Since we'll pass an input parameter in the call method, we'll not create input objects in this method. Here, we'll just create two normalization layers for the two inputs. Let's use the self keyword, as these will be the attributes of the instances. Let's write self norm layer wide equals tf keras layers normalization. After that, let's write self norm layer deep equals tf keras layers normalization. Cool, we have created our input layers. It's time to create two hidden layers. Let's define these layers. Let's write self hidden one equals tf keras layers dense units activation equals let's give activation. After that, let's write self hidden two equals tf keras layers dense units activation equals let's give activation. Cool, we created two hidden layers. Next, let's create the output layer. Since our problem is regression, we'll only estimate a numerical value. So, let's pass a neuron to this layer. Let's set self main output equals tf keras layers dense let's give 1. Awesome, we have defined the layers we will use in the neural network. Now, let's build a deep neural network model using these layers. To do this, we're going to use the call method. Let's write def call let's set self, inputs. Since we have two inputs, let's set them. Let's set input wide, input deep equals inputs. First, let's set the path for the wide data. The data will pass through the normalization layer and go directly to the output layer. Let's write norm wide equals self norm layer wide. Let's give input wide. Keep in mind that this path will go directly to the output layer. Now let's determine the deep path. Let's go the data through the normalization layer first. Let's write norm deep equals self norm layer deep. Let's give input deep. Note that we set the output of one layer as the input of the other layer. Next, let's pass the data through the first hidden layer. Let's write hidden one equals self hidden one. Let's give norm deep. Then let's go through the second hidden layer. Let's write hidden two equals self hidden two. Let's give hidden one. Nice. We set the layers. Our inputs will pass through. Now let's combine these two inputs with the concatenate layer. Note that we didn't define this layer in the init function. We're going to use this layer directly here. Let's write concat equals tf keras layers concatenate. Let's give norm wide and hidden two. Let's pass this combined data through the output layer. Let's write output equals self main output. Let's give concat. Let's return the latest output using the return keyword. Let's set return output. Nice. So we've built the architecture of our model. Now let's create an object from the class. First, let's use the set seed method to fix the randomness. Let's set tf random set seed. Let's give 42. It's time to instantiate an object of the class. Let's pass this object to 30 neurons, and for the activation parameter, let's give the rela function. Let's say model equals mimodel. Let's set 30 activation equals let's give relu. Nice, we created a model. Let's go ahead and compile the model. In this step, we'll determine the loss, optimizer, and metrics. First, let's create an optimizer variable. Let's use the atom optimizer. And then, let's specify the learning rate. Let's say optimizer equals tf keras optimizers atom. Let's set learning rate. Now, let's call the compile method and specify the parameters. Let's set model compile loss equals let's give MSE optimizer equals let's give optimizer metrics equals let's give root mean squared error. Cool, we compiled our model. Our model will have two inputs, right? Now, let's create these entries. Let's first create the inputs for the training. Our dataset consists of 7 features. Let the first 5 features be the wide input, the last 5 features be the deep input. Let's set xtrain wide xtrain deep equals strain 5 and then xtrain 2. Let's create the inputs for the test data. Let's set xtest wide xtest deep equals xtest 5 xtest 2. Nice, we've created our input data for the model. Now, let's move on to training the model. Before we train the model, we need to use the adapt method for the model's normalization layer. What does the adapt method do? It learns statistics, such as mean and variance from training data. After that, these statistics use for test data. Now, let's use the adapt method to learn the statistics of inputs. Let's set model norm layer wide adapt. Let's give xtrain wide. After that, let's set model norm layer deep adapt. Let's give xtrain deep. Next, let's call the fit method to train the model. Let's say history equals model fit. Let's give the inputs xtrain wide and xtrain deep. Next, let's set the output, etrain. And then, we want to use the validation data. To do this, let's set validation split 0.1. For the epochs number, let's set 10. When we run these codes, model training starts. Here, you can see the loss and metric values for the training and validation data. Cool, we trained our model. Note that, we can improve the performance of the model, by fine-tuning the hyperparameter, but in this video, I just want to cover the Keras subclassing API. In the next videos, we'll talk about how to fine-tune the hyperparameter. Now let's test the model using the test data. Let's set eval results equals model, let's call the evaluate method. After that, let's set the text inputs, xtest wide and xtest deep. Let's set the output data, itest. To see the results, let's write eval results. You can see the loss and metric values of our model on the test data here. Now, let's take a look at how our model predicts the new data. First, let's take a few examples of test data. Let's say x new wide x new deep equals x test wide 3 and then x test deep 3. Nice, we have sample data. Now, let's predict the labels of this data using our model. For this, we will call the predict method. Let's say iPerd model, let's call the predict method, let's give x new wide x new deep. Nice, labels predicted. Let's see these labels. Let's write iPerd. These are the values predicted by the model. Now let's look at the actual values. Let's write itest 3. These values are real values. As you can see, our model is not very bad. Note that you can improve this model by fine-tuning the hyperparameter. As a result, the best way to build complex models is the subclassing method. But you need to write more code for this method. As a rule of thumb, unless you want to build a very complex model, I recommend using the sequential API or functional API. These methods solve most of your problems. Before you finish the video, don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and share it with your friends. We also create content on our other social media accounts. We will be happy if you follow us. See you in the next videos. Bye for now.